Hello, ladies and gents. Greg M. Life on the go. Found some videos showing the receipts of my accomplishment, my first big accomplishment as a track and field athlete, fresh out of high school. It's the 1984 Olympics, where I ran the 4x100 meter relay on the second leg, ran the heat semifinal and final, so I earned every bit of it. And we accomplished second place silver medal to the United States. So it was me, Albert Lawrence, Donald Quarter, Raymond Stewart, of course, I'm Greg Magoo. I'll put a little bit of information in the video so you can see a little bit more. But, you know, just to let you know, I'm just not somebody that don't know what I'm talking about or have any kind of experience. So, you know, it's a little throwback. So check it out. Hope you enjoy. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Greg M. Life on the Go Sports Update. This is a little bit about my track and field career that I had. It's my first time at this level, something that I dreamed about. The 1984 Olympics, where I won this silver medal. I was part of a silver medal team. That's the starting leg there, Albert Lawrence. It was two high school guys in the Jamaica team, myself, which we had just graduated high school. This day is on my birthday that I'm also competing, August 11, 1984. You know, as you say, this is the receipts to some of my experience. You know, you see people on YouTube and they talk about what they know and do or whatever, but they may not have the proof. Well, here's one of the proof. And I can show you results, Wikipedia information, stuff like that. But check this out. You're not going to, the US coverage was very bad. In the beginning, they showed the intro of everybody getting ready for the setup for the 4x1. Of course, you're only going to see me waiting to get the stick. We're in lane one. So, you know, US is in lane five. And once we get the stick and this, the exchange over the first exchange to the second leg, you don't see me anymore. You only see the third leg exchange a little bit. Then you see the anchor with Raymond Stewart, which is the other high school athlete. I think we might have been the only two high school guys at that level that I remember or know of that was competing in the 1984 Olympics. Check this out.
Relay. They've got the team from Jamaica. Their leadoff runner is Albert Lawrence. In lane one, they have Donald Quarry running the third leg and Ray Stewart running anchor for them. West Germany will be in lane two. Rob Lukey will run the anchor leg. Lane three, the first leg will be run by Antonio Muro of Italy with Pietro Manea running anchor. There he is, the gold medalist. The back-to-back Olympics. Daily Thompson starts for Great Britain. Their team anchored by Alan Wells. And then you have Sam Brady, who'll give it to Ron Brown, who'll turn it over to Calvin Smith. And then over to Carl Lewis in lane five. Ben Johnson, the bronze medalist in 200 for Canada. Sterling Collins running anchor. France in lane seven. Antoine Richard starting. And Arnaldo Silva will lead things off for Brazil. But all eyes and the commissary of most anyway will be focused on lane five. Waits at the southwest end of the Coliseum. The fourth and final leg will be run by Lewis in his attempt to duplicate the feat accomplished by Jesse Owens in 1936. And there is Calvin Smith, who could not even qualify for the open 100. World record holder 9.9 breaking, they did 9.94 already this year, and Ron Brown. So the moment is now here for Lewis and company, OJ.
Yes, Al, I tell you, I think my favorite event is the relay, and that's, I'm a little excited here.
Ron Brown, they just showed. I was on that same second leg with Ron Brown. Imagine me. I was 18, turning 19 that day. Nervous as hell. This is like my big moment. Cannot disappoint. I have to go back, you know, stop a little bit. You know, my team didn't have as much confidence in me as a young buck. Even though Raymond Stewart was on the team, his coach was one of the head coaches. Well, of course, he's going to let his boy run. But, you know, with me, they wanted to use one of the other guys. I made the team official. I was the top 3 in Jamaica, right? But I didn't hit the qualifying 100 meter time for the Olympics. I qualified later, but they had already replaced me with someone else, one of the college guys, and then they wanted to use that guy in the finals also. Just to let you know, I ended up running the heat, semifinals, and finals. So, but I showed them that I could do it. I believed in myself, and I got it done. They're just focusing on you, United States. Sam Gretti.
He was a silver medal winner in the open 100 meters. So we don't expect to be in the lead after the first leg, but we should have some good competition. And hopefully they negotiate that pass and we'll keep a good eye on that first one. We'll see if they've decided to go for it.
Sam Gretti in the blocks. Lewis waiting. He'll get the baton about 30 seconds after the start.
There I am waiting. That's about it. I'm trailing from lane one. I'm in lane one, but they're not showing me. They're just showing these guys up front in the U.S. Donald Quarry is coming around now. It was hard out of lane one. Then there's our guy. We couldn't have gotten that far if we didn't have good baton exchanges. World record. And see, we placed second, the Jamaica team, with 2 high school graduates. So that was an accomplishment right there. Let me just finish this out a little bit. World record at the time. They had to run a world record to beat us with 2 high school guys. Not bad. Of course, I'm walking around the track somewhere. I was so in shock, young buck. This is the Olympics, I used to dream about. 37.84 was the world record at the time. Of course, several years in the future, Jamaica tore that up with Usain Bolt. They're doing their little victory lap. By that time, I'm walking off somewhere, but. Yep. So that's a little bit, you didn't get to see us just to finish, but you know Jamaica got second. I ran that second leg. The 1988 Olympics was my second Olympics. That gave me a better look. I ran the second leg again. That gave me a better look. Maybe I'll find that video in the future and show that also sometime soon. All right, folks. This is after the competition of the 4x100 meter relay men's finals that I was a part of for Jamaica, that is, in Los Angeles. This is the award ceremony where you can get a better look at me. I'll probably have to stop the video just to show you who I am. I'm now 19 years old, and this is my birthday when I won the silver medal as part of the Jamaican national team.
Thank you.
They're zooming in. That's me right there. That's Raymond Stewart. You can't listen. Look at that. Ben Johnson right there. Of course, they're focusing on the United States. That was a big accomplishment for me, coming from Jamaica, high school graduate of San Diego High School, Monk Street, Spanish Town. See if we're showing our shot. There it is. That's us there. Jamaica's in the yellow. In the yellow tracksuit. That's it, folks. Me getting my silver medal. My back turn right there now. That's as good as it gets. Poor quality, but that's just some of my accomplishment right there. Went on from there, was living the dream of the amazement of making it to the Olympics, something that I never really thought I would be at, you know. But hope you enjoyed this, a throwback of my some of my accomplishment back then. I went on from there to Abilene Christian University Division II school.